Let's get into some of the customizations you can enjoy with MixItUp. The settings cog can be found in the top right corner of the app. Click on that to bring up the settings window. Once here on the left, you'll see a bunch of areas you can configure. I won't cover all of them, I'll let you explore them on your own, but I will highlight a few interesting ones. Themes and colors allow you to change the look and feel of MixItUp. You'll have noticed I have a darker theme in this tutorial, whereas in my previous video, I used the default white and blue. Have a play and see what works for you. In the chat settings, you can set how MixItUp chat looks for you, making the text larger or customizing colors for various roles. If the command actions menu is too overwhelming for you, head over to the commands and you can filter out things you don't care about, making that action list shorter and easier to navigate. Finally, and most importantly, under advanced, you can set the backup location and rate. I have mine set to daily. This means MixItUp will backup on a daily basis, so should anything go wrong, I have a relatively recent fallback. We're going to look at counters a bit later on, but first, let's dig into overlays. We've already seen how to get a single overlay into OBS from MixItUp. But did you know that MixItUp allows you to have multiple overlays? Multiple overlays allow you to have more flexibility over where particular elements appear on screen, as well as open up the doors to overlay widgets, which we're going to get into in a bit. For now, let me show you exactly how to set up a new overlay. In settings, go to the overlay section. Here you will see your default overlay and its address. Adding another overlay is as simple as giving it a name and clicking add. I'm going to call mine Death Counter. Yep, that's what we're going to do next. Once you've done that, just copy the URL and paste it into OBS as we did before to add it as a browser source. One important thing to note at this point is that where the default overlay can be auto-refreshed by MixItUp when it starts, there's no way to make additional overlays auto-refresh. So if your overlay disconnects from OBS, you will need to refresh it yourself. Thankfully, this is very easy to do. Simply click the refresh button in OBS if you find your additional overlays are not working. Having set up an additional overlay, let's put it to use with an overlay widget. Before we move on, if you're finding this video useful, please do remember to drop a like and consider hitting that subscribe button. In the previous section, we set up an overlay called Death Counter, and we'll use that now to create an overlay widget to track our in-game deaths. After having created the overlay we want to use to display our death counter, let's go and create the actual counter. Before we do that, let me explain how a counter works in MixItUp. In settings, click on counters. You can add a new counter here and set some options for it. Here you will need to add a counter name. Note in the instructions it says that only letters and numbers are allowed. You cannot use a dollar sign. You'll know now that dollar signs are reserved by MixItUp for special identifiers. You may have worked out by now that by creating a counter you are in fact creating a new special identifier that you can call anywhere in MixItUp. Let's call this counter Death. We now have two further options, save to file and reset on load. If we save this counter to a file, it will remain backed up and can be used again another day. Reset on load will reset the counter to zero each time MixItUp loads. Finally, if you want to set an initial amount for the counter to be set to, you can put that into amount. You can also update the amount at any time after the counter has been created. Now we've made the overlay and the counter, let's display it on screen. Click on the hamburger menu and go to Overlay Widgets. Here you want to click Add Overlay Widget. You'll get a new pop-up that you won't have seen before. From the Type drop-down, there will also be new options you may not be familiar with. For now, just select Text. Do feel free to explore the other options to see what they do, as I won't be covering them all. The next screen will seem a little familiar to you. It's in part a bit like the overlay action we used in the command editor window in the last tutorial. set a name for the widget, and under Overlay, select Death Counter. You can select the place you want the death counter to appear, but I want to show you the advantage of using multiple overlays, so go ahead and keep it in the center. For the refresh time, you want to set it to 1. What this means is that the overlay will refresh every 1 second. If you put it to 0, it will never update when the value changes. And if you set it to a higher number, it will take that many seconds between when you update the counter for it to change on screen. For a death counter, I'd want it to update pretty much instantly, so I'll set it to 1 second. Set the font, color, and size to whatever you like. Finally, in the text area, you'll want to type something like this: deaths, $death. If you remember, our counter is called death, which is now a special identifier. Save that and make sure the overlay is enabled. Now, head over to OBS. As this overlay is only used for a death counter, we can make it any size we want. Let's resize it, crop it, and move it to wherever we like. Any changes made to this overlay will not affect our other alerts that we have already set up, as they are on their own overlay. Right, we have a counter, we have an overlay. We can display that overlay, but now we need to update the counter. Let's go back to MixItUp and select commands from the hamburger menu. Create a new command and call it addDeath. Under the action, select counter, create an update. I think you can see where we're going with this. Set the counter name, which in this case is death. You'll notice that there's the same options here where we created the counter: save to file and reset on load. As we have already created the death counter, it won't make it again, it will simply update it. Select update and put the number 1 under amount. This will just add 1 to whatever is on the counter right now. You can also see that we can reset or set a specific number to the counter. If you change the amount to -1 instead of 1, it will subtract 1 from whatever the counter is. You might need to do that if you accidentally add too much to the counter by mistake and want to take some away. After we make this command, you can create a subtract death and reset death commands if you wish. Personally, I do not want anyone in chat to be able to add a death, so I like to set the permissions to streamer only. Finally, go ahead and test the command. Hit play, and you should see the overlay in OBS update. In the hamburger menu, you'll see timers. These actually refer to scheduled commands, which we'll cover later on. For on-screen timers, you'll want to head over to overlay widgets. But before that, let's create a new overlay for our timer. Go to settings and create a new timer overlay. Once we've done that, go to overlay widgets from the hamburger menu and create a new overlay widget of type timer. You'll see in the description that it states the timer counts down when the widget is visible, and hiding it resets the timer. Let's add it now. As with the counter, let's name the widget, set the overlay to the timer overlay we just created, and set the font to whatever you like. Under length, put how long you want the timer to last. If it's a silly hat redeem, I would put something like 10 minutes, which is 600 seconds. But for this test, I'm just going to set it to 5 seconds. You'll notice there's an option to add a command for when the timer completes. Clicking that will take you to the command editor window, where you'll be able to add any actions you'd like. I like to play a sound when the timer runs out, so that I know when it's finished. Go ahead and save this, but make sure the timer is disabled. Remember, the timer counts down when visible, so if we make it visible now, it will start counting down immediately. To test this out, let's first create a Twitch channel point redeem that triggers the timer to appear. I've already made one here to wear a hat. In the command editor for the redeem, you want to select overlay images and video, and in the action, select overlay widget. From the dropdown, select the timer widget and make it visible. So when a user redeems this, it will show the widget on the overlay. When the timer is up, the widget will vanish, and the sound will play. We can test it out by hitting the play button, or saving it and heading over to OBS and selecting the redeem from the channel point menu. Don't forget to resize, crop, and place your timer overlay wherever you like. There you go. Now, time for something completely different before we come back to overlays at the end. From time to time, you may want to remind viewers of certain things, such as other places they can find you online, or to remember to add fun quotes, or to join your Discord server. Instead of typing these out frequently, or calling a command from the chat window, you can schedule commands to fire at regular intervals. MixItUp calls these timers. Click on the hamburger menu and go to timers. A timer is any command or a series of commands that runs at regular intervals. As an example, I'm going to make a simple chat message, but you can have any command action you wish. A video, a sound, a message, scrolling text, it's completely up to you. Click on New Command and you'll see the command editor window. Add what you want the command to do and give it a name. Once that's saved, you can set your interval minutes, which is how long there should be between each message posted, and the minimum number of messages in chat between the messages. For example, let's say we set our interval for 30 minutes and our minimum messages to 5. This means that once a scheduled command is run, MixItUp will wait for 30 minutes to pass and make sure that at least 5 messages have been posted in your chat before firing the next schedule command. Both of these criteria must be fulfilled before the next command will be called. If you make multiple timers in here, it will run them in order, cycling through each one every 30 minutes. Once it's cycled through all the timers, it will start from the top again. If you don't care too much about how often or which command is fired, you can click on Randomize Timers, which will select a random command and run it at varied intervals. There is another more complicated level to configuring timers, which we may get into in the third tutorial of the series. If you'd like me to cover that topic, please leave a comment below and I'll be sure to include it. For the final part of this tutorial, we're going to cover how to get Twitch chat up on your stream. Firstly, create a new overlay in Settings. Call it Chat. Get that into OBS, sizing it and positioning it where you'd like your chat to appear. Then, click on the hamburger menu and navigate to Overlay Widgets. The widget we're interested in is Chat Message, so go ahead and add that. You'll notice for chat there's no refresh time. The chat updates automatically when new messages appear. As with the other widgets, configure the position and font. You also have some new options here to do with how the chat messages should appear. You can have a border around the messages, a background color, and some animations. Play around with these and see what suits you best. At the bottom, you will have noticed there is a HTML style section. This is available on all overlay widgets, and if you have some skill with HTML and inline styling, you can edit this yourself to change the look of the chat box. Hit save and head on over to OBS. Type in some messages into chat and see them appear on screen. Simple. I hope you found this tutorial useful. I will be covering more advanced topics in the third part of this series, which should be arriving soon. So if there's anything you'd like included in there, please leave it in the comments below. Remember, you can find me on Twitch, That British Mo, and all the normal social media channels. Catch you again soon.